Hi, I'm Shane, and welcome to Lohre Farm. We're going to get, I think we're going to let the chickens go and run around and be free. They've been locked up for a couple of weeks as we've been getting the garden ready. Otherwise, they'll get in, eat all the seeds. So we're going to let them out today, let them go roam free wherever they want to go. Hopefully, they stay on my property. They mostly just stay in the woods for the most part, but we're gonna do that today. And I was doing a little bit of bell training with them. So basically I just mounted this bell to the side of the barn here. That way it's easy access anytime I need to get it and just ring it anytime I need to get them back. They come running for the treat and we can lock them right up inside the coop. It works out really handy, you know, if we're gonna leave and maybe be gone for the night, but they've been out scavenging all day and I need them to get back. So I just rang the bell and now they're all just standing here waiting, looking at me. Where's my treat? Give me my treat. Where's my, I see you. How you girls doing today? How you doing there, mister? Big fat chicken, looking good. You wanna get out and play today? Yeah, I think we're gonna look at the garden and make an assessment, but I think you guys are gonna get to go free today and go run around. Hey, there you are. Hi, Deuce. How's it going? Keeping an eye on things? All right, well, you guys enjoy your treat. I'll be back in a little bit. All right, well, let's go take a look at these gardens. They're doing pretty good. This stuff is growing really, really fast. And actually, they're calling for the weather this next week to be almost 100 degrees. So if we keep these things watered real good, they are going to be absolutely growing like crazy. So things are looking pretty good though. The potatoes are sure getting pretty tall and the tomato plants are looking real healthy. They'll take off this week. Green beans are starting to come in. Looking good. Those tomato plants are looking real sharp. Got a bunch of beets coming in. That's looking pretty good. Growing up real quick. Oh, I gotta show you guys this stuff in the greenhouse. You won't believe it. Look at how fast these beans are coming up. It's only been a couple of days. Starting to get a little bit of beets coming up in there. Green beans going in here. Got some more beets coming up over here. Yeah, I can't believe how fast this is coming up, but this is the power of a greenhouse. If you can put in a greenhouse, just that little bit of extra heat during the night, I think that really, really supercharges everything. Well, one of the things that I'm gonna be working on today is putting down some grass seed out here in front of the barn. During the winter, I plowed all the snow so that this would be pretty nice to be able to drive down here and drop supplies off in the barn. But one thing that it did is it pretty much wiped the grass out. It's pretty much all weeds. So I'm gonna go through here and put a bunch of grass seed down, being that it's gonna be so warm over the next few days. This stuff will pop up immediately and be ready to go. I hooked the disc up to the back of the tractor. I'm just gonna go through it, just kind of turn some of that soil up. Then I'm gonna spread all that grass seed out and then I'll go back through it again with the disc a couple of times. And we'll be able to put that grass seed in really nice and simple, and all I'll have to do is drive the tractor. Well, this is looking pretty good. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let the sun swing around here and heat this up a little bit and let it dry out just a little bit. And I'll come back out here and put the seed down. You'll see when this is all done, this will be just perfectly granular. It'll be just the nicest soil you've ever seen as soon as I go through it a few more times. So this will work out perfect. And I haven't even had to pick up a rake. So we'll just let the tractor sit here and chill out for a little bit. We'll get on to some other stuff. We'll come back to that. The other cool thing that I'm gonna show you today is what we do with our grass clippings. See, we use our grass clippings in the garden as our weed mitigation. It's worked out fantastic for the past couple of years. And I'm gonna continue doing it. I don't see any reason why I shouldn't just keep using grass clippings out there. There's a couple of things that you need to do to keep it so your fruits and vegetables are safe. Boy, does that work good for getting rid of the weeds and keeping them kind of, you know, if the sun can't get to them, then they can't get made, and you end up with a really nice healthy garden. And there's a huge benefit at the end too. You're putting all that extra compost into the soil. I think it's a benefit all around. If it's still a little bit green when I put it down, it's just a little bit easier to kind of keep matted and keep in place. And the other thing that I've figured out is initially you want to keep a little bit of a distance between the grass and the stem of the vegetable itself, just keeping it a little bit away from it. Otherwise you will get a little bit of almost what is like leaf burn on the plant. Here's an example of the leaf burn I was talking about, where it's just a little bit too close to the leaf.
All right, girls, we'll play, be good, come back when I call.
Well, the chickens have been running around for about a half an hour. They look like they're enjoying themselves. Having fun, girls? Well, and I'm sorry there, sir, I see you. Having fun there, sir? Yeah, you guys look like you're having fun already, finding all kinds of good stuff out here. So, while we're talking about the chickens, if you're getting anything out of our content, I'm gonna really encourage you right now, go ahead and peck that like button. Give us a like on the channel and give us a like on the video. It really helps out with YouTube's algorithm and will help push this video out to more people. Just peck that like button and thank you. Well, I let the sun beat on the area for a little while. Now I'm gonna run through with this tine harrow that I got. Actually, nice enough, my neighbor gave it to me. He must have used it a few times and they kind of left it out on the edge of the property line, and I was out there and noticed that it was sitting there one day and figured it was his since he owned all the land prior to me, and asked him about it, and he said, yeah, if you want it, it's yours, you can have it. And actually he also gave me my my disc harrow. Well, the chickens have been out and about now for a couple of hours, so they're kind of spread all over the place, but let's see how this goes. Let's try to call them back in. Well, I think overall that was pretty successful. I think they all came back. We'll have to do a head count later on and see where we're at.